have to fight our own fight to get this. So I'm going to start off. I want to start actually by thanking the National Collective for inviting me to be part of this evening, sitting on the end here listening to you. I thought, what should I do? I know what. I'll start with a song about being English. The Union Jack, it clashes with the sunset, and put it in the attic with the Emperor's old clothes. When did it fall apart? Sometime in the 80s, when the great and the good gave way to the greedy and the mean. Britain isn't cool, you know, it's really not that great. It's not a proper country, doesn't even have a patron saint. It's just an economic union that's passed its sell-by date. Take down the Union Jack, it clashes with the sunset, and ask our Scottish neighbours if independence looks any good, cause they just might have a clue how to take an abstract notion of personal identity and turn it into nationhood. Is this the 19th century that I'm watching on TV? The dear old Queen of England handing out those MBEs. Member of the British Empire, that doesn't sound too good to me. And George are taking the piss, aren't they? Gilbert and George are taking the piss. What could be more British than here's a picture of me bum? Gilbert and George are taking the piss. Take down the Union Jack, it clashes with the sunset, and pile up all those history books, but don't throw them away, cause they just might have a clue about what it really means to be an Anglo-Saxon in England.co.uk. To be an Anglo-Saxon in England.co.uk.
Thank you.
Yes, there are many of us in England who are highly envious of the fact that you have a border between yourselves and Westminster. We don't, and it causes all sorts of unimaginable little problems that, as a nation, we English are almost invisible in our own country. You know, there is no Museum of English History where you can go in and learn the chronological history of England. As a result from that, many people who come to our country see the English as an ethnic group of white ethnic group, and it's a real problem that we have, and that does need to be challenged. And the referendum you're about to have obviously directly challenges that. But that national idea is not really why I'm so interested in what you're about to do. I'm interested in what you're about to do because it is ultimately about self-determination rather than nationalism. And I've felt for a long time now that the only real way to deal with globalised capital is to have greater accountability.
not just political accountability, but economic accountability as well, to hold capitalism to account, to be able to hold the bankers to account, to be able to hold the corporations to account, the tax dodgers to account. How do we do that? It seems to me the way we do that is we give people more power locally, devolve more power. But the devolution agenda, just nobody speaks about it in England. And nobody's going to speak about it in England either, unless you take the decision to become independent. Then all this stuff comes into play. Everything comes onto the table. And that's why for some of us in England, the prospect of an independent Scotland is really, really enticing. I don't know what kind of Scotland it'll be. We all of us have our dark sides within our culture. You know, racism, sectarianism, we all have those people. There's a right in your country, there's a right in my country, but ultimately I have faith in people, that if people are given the opportunity to express themselves as a community, that they will express a positive side. Because the kind of society that I want to live in, I want to live in a compassionate society. And that's about as far as I've gone with that kind of thinking. And I'm not really seeing that on the ballot at the next election for me in the United Kingdom. So I want to dedicate this to you with respect. It's called I Keep Faith. If you want to make the weather, have to take the blame. If sometimes dark clouds fill the sky and it starts to rain and folks complain, and though your head may tell you to run and hide, listen to your heart and you'll find me right by your side. Because I keep faith, I keep faith, I keep faith. Faith in you, yes I do, I keep faith in you. If you think you have the answer, well, don't be surprised if what you say is met with anger, contempt and lies. No matter how hard you may want to, just walk away. Reach out, you'll find me there beside you all of the way. Because I keep faith, I keep faith, I keep faith, I keep faith in you, yes I do, I keep faith in you. All the dreams we shared, never knew no one who cared about these things the way that I've seen you. Doesn't matter if this all falls off the cliff, together we are gonna see it through. Now I know it takes a mess of courage to go against the grain. You have to make great sacrifice for such little gain. So much pain. And if your plans have come to nothing, washed out in the rain, let me rekindle all your hopes and help you start again. Because I keep faith in these troubled times. I keep faith in these uncertain days. I keep faith. I keep faith in you. Yes, I do. I keep faith in every single one of you. I keep faith in you. Yes, I do. I keep faith in every single one of you. I keep faith in you. Yes, I do. I keep faith in you. I keep faith in you. I'm going to get home tomorrow for the first time for a couple of weeks, and I'm really hoping that the scaffolders have been took the scaffolding down from our windows. Because it's been up for ages. They've left it there over the summer. I don't know where they've gone. Just, I'm very fortunate I live on a beach in the south of England. Yeah, that's what you do if you sing about socialism. You end up... sun-seeing socialism. That's what I believe in. And if they had told us before that we were going to have all this bloody palaver, if someone had come round and explained to us all of what's happened, I'd have thought to myself, bloody hell, that's going to be a bit serious. But now it's all done, we've got this absolutely beautiful view out towards the Isle of Portland. You know, we've undoubtedly added some value to our property, and bugger me, the neighbours are going to do the same now. So, my point is, you know, when the debate happens on Monday night, you will undoubtedly be told how awful it will be. And it will be, you know, it's going to be bumpy. You're going to go, you're going to undoubtedly have turbulence. This kind of change doesn't just happen. You wake up one morning, it's all... think how long the Irish took to get their independence, you know? They knew that outside of Great Britain, they would be poorer. They would be a small agricultural country, leaving a large industrial country, but they still believe that independence was more important than that, you know? When we try to bring about change, our enemy is not so much capitalism or conservatism. Our enemy really is cynicism. You know, if we're talking about the independence referendum or trying to hold capitalism to account, cynicism is our greatest enemy. I don't even mean the cynicism of the Daily Mail, that's their job. You know, that's how they make their living, honestly, mate. You know, they want you to think that nobody else gives a shit. That's what they're doing, that's their job. No, the cynicism that is our real enemy, when we want to bring real change to society, is our own cynicism. Our own sense that nothing will ever change, our own sense that nobody else cares about this shit, our own sense that politicians are all the same. And we have to fight that all the time, myself included, I have to fight my own cynicism. And I'm not talking about doubt, you know, never trust anyone who has no doubts, because they're either a religious maniac or someone from the SWP trying to sell you a newspaper. Neither of them had much of a sense of humour, if I remember right. Doubt is very important. I'm not talking about scepticism. I'm always willing to debate with someone who's sceptical about something. But a cynic is someone who has already given up. And they want you to give up too, so it makes them feel better. I've no time for those people anymore, you know? I'm trying to get the wherewithal to do something. And whatever the outcome... Remember, it did take you two goes last time. So whatever the outcome, just saying, whatever the outcome, be assured that you have changed the dynamic in this little island of ours forever with this debate, with this referendum. We no longer look at ourselves the same. We no longer think of ourselves the same. We no longer have that taken for granted sense of who we are. Because to tell you the truth, those of us south of the border, we don't really know who we are. We're still singing God Save the Queen at the football, for fuck's sake, you know. A country that doesn't even mention, a song that doesn't even mention the name of our country. You know, we're still wrapped up in that empire bullshit, you know. We're all still gung-ho for that, and we need waking up from that, and we're not going to wake up ourselves. That alarm clock has not yet been set. And nobody in Westminster is going to want to poke that one particularly, because there might be some nasty ideas that come out of it. But you know, we've dealt with those nasty ideas. You know, we had the BNP, we dealt with those bastards. You know, and we've dealt with the EDF, and we'll deal with UKIP as well. Because fundamentally, the English people are as compassionate as any of you here.
So I just want to say, whatever happens on September the 18th, I'll be doing a gig in New York. I'll read about it. It's the way it is. Some of us have a job. But the relationship between our country has changed. But find, I don't know how, but find some way to invite us into that journey with you, wherever you're going to go, even if it's being a separate country. You know, we may not live in the same house anymore, but we're not going anywhere, are we? We're all still going to be here. And I think that that we have a lot to learn from the way that you've rediscovered yourself, the way you have kind of like shaken off the mantle of empire and rather cleverly handed it to us. Yeah, I saw that. I saw that. But seriously, it's, you know, we desperately in England, we need to have this conversation as well, not just about who we are, but about devolution, about how you bring power back to people. You know, I live in the southwest of England. Give me a regional assembly with Holyrood powers down in Bristol or somewhere like that, so we can start to take on the economic power of London and the southeast.
Spring-bearing jasmine and rose, what summer in all its gay train, or autumn, the splendor of autumn, to those who've bartered their freedom for gain. Let the love of our land's sacred rights to the love of our people succeed. Let friendship and honor unite and flourish on both sides the Tweed. Virtue distinguish the brave, place riches in lowest degree, think them poorest who would be a slave, and richest who dares to be free. Let the love of our land's sacred rights to the love of our people succeed. Let friendship and honor unite and flourish on both sides the Tweed. Let the love of our land's sacred rights to the love of our people succeed. Let friendship and honor unite and flourish on both sides the Tweed.
Thank you very much.